Hey everyone, it's Glenn with the Cactus Atlas, and today I'm exploring Aztec Ruins National Monument.
When you enter in the front of Aztec, you have to go through the visitor center and the museum. So, needless to say, I highly recommend walking through the museum. There are some really cool things in there. You learn a little bit about this place, when it was built, by whom, who the descendants of these people are thought to be today. Tribes like the Navajo, the Utes, the Zuni, the Hopi. And you see a lot of really awesome pottery on display, woven materials like old sandals, things these people actually made with their own hands.
And if I'm being fair, this museum was actually better than the visitor centers at Chaco Canyon, because at Chaco, for whatever reason, most of the display cases were empty because those things were on loan and then since moved. This place has lots of things to take a look at in there, so really good visitor center. These folks are thought to have built this based on the architecture of the Chacoan culture that we had seen in Chaco Canyon. So they think this was built between 1110 and 1130. So this would have been after Pueblo Benito, probably the most famous of the great houses in Chaco Canyon was completed. They think that architects from down there came up here to build this, which ended up being probably the second largest of the great houses in this entire region during that time.
So what I'm expecting to see as we walk through this are a lot of similarities from what we had seen in Chaco. So I'm looking to compare and contrast.
And would you look at that right behind me? Aztec ruins, this great house, this pueblo. What we're gonna end up doing is, I think there's about an 800 yard trail that cuts through this. So the person at the desk, I was asking her questions, she said that this is gonna feel very similar to Pueblo Benito. So if I liked that, I'm supposed to like this. Now, this isn't quite as large as Pueblo Benito, but I think there's even a section where we get to go inside some things, and they even recreated a Great Kiva, so we can actually experience what a kiva would have looked like at the time. Up until now at Chaco, we just saw the remnants, basically the very well-preserved remnants, the stone, but we didn't really see it painted or plastered or any of that. So that's one of the highlights here, is to really get a glimpse into what a Great Kiva would have been like on the inside.
Oh, and I can tell there's gonna be a reveal here. There's gonna be a reveal. Oh my goodness. This is amazing. This, I would say, is as good as stuff you'd see at Chaco. You could see the trail that we're gonna do. It's pretty short. So this might be a shorter video, and that's okay. But this is amazing. And yeah, it does look like Chaco, except for the surrounding terrain. That's the only difference, really. And other things that I'm noticing from up here would be lots of wooden beams. These people up here at this higher elevation probably had better access to that than the people in Chaco Canyon, I'm gonna assume. But the really cool thing about the wood here is that in these places, it's usually original. You're talking like 900 years old or something like that. And they used the wood to date the place very accurately, and in the visitor center you can learn about how they use dendrochronology to date these structures. I might talk a little bit about that, but you might want to watch our Chaco content too, because I go into a lot of that on that video.
And interestingly, the lady in the visitor center said this whole thing took maybe about 30 years to complete, unlike what you saw at Chaco, which took centuries because they kept building on top of stuff. So the theory that the lady inside offered me is that the architects from Chaco were already really familiar with how to do this, so by the time they come up here, they got it done really fast. The people that built this, just like the people in Chaco Canyon, are referred to as the Ancestral Puebloan people. Archaeologists have given them different names, like the Anasazi, but I think what's socially acceptable, the best choice, is to call them Ancestral Puebloan.
And unlike Chaco, if you have accessibility needs, I think what I could see this trail winding through is completely paved. Unlike visiting Chaco, which you don't really see as much paved. You see a lot of gravel paths and things like that, but this definitely seems more accessible. And the first thing that I am encountering here is the kiva. and I think I even see the entrance, so I might want to sneak in there in the event that nobody's in there yet so I can film and blab. Okay, so this is a one-way thing, so I'm wondering if there's a north and south entrance, but they do want you to be respectful and quiet because I think this is a real thing. So, and it looks like they may even have bats in here. And already you can see the pigment, the red on the wall. Maybe original wood. I'm guessing they made this stairway a little easier to climb down than the natives would have had. I think the ones we saw at Chaco were much more steep, but look at this. I mean, you can see right off the bat, if you're comparing this to Chaco, what we really saw was the round part dug in. None of the roofs were left. Like you see here, all of these wooden beams. None of the ones that we saw had like plastered walls or stuccoed walls like this either. And certainly none of them had this color that you see. So this is more representative of what I think the people, what these things looked like when they were in use. And I've not actually been down in one. So this is another thing that I could add to my list here. It's one thing when you're looking down into one of these and you do realize that the walls are really steep, so steep that if you fell into one and there was no ladder, you'd struggle to get out of it. But being inside, down in this, gives it a whole new perspective. I saw this sign, I'm like, what ladders are they talking about? Well, I'm guessing that each of these things are ladders that people could have climbed through these various portals here that are surrounding this whole thing. The temperature in here is much cooler than outside. First of all, being out of the sun, but I'm gonna guess it's like 10, 15 degrees cooler in this nice shady cave, this kiva. All right, let's go back outside now and see what else we can find. Ah, back into the hot, bright sun. Oh, and that's how you get into these little rooms here. There's like individual ones, each with its own ladder. So these little rooms are curious. I guess maybe this is where the common people entered. They wanted to make it difficult on them, but each one has its own door that you can go in and look. And then each one has its own ladder to go down. Okay, now that we're back out into the heat, there's so much more to see. Now you can't go into all the ruins, but I think towards the end is where we might be able to go in. And this is well timed because I'm gonna guess this is another kiva. This one very much like the ones in Chaco. No roofs. All you can really do is look down into them. And you can see how deep they go. And this one's much smaller than the Great Kiva behind. But this gives you a really good idea of how most kivas look today. Looks like here's a route where we can actually go through part of the ruins, just like at Pueblo Pinito. Almost the same thing where you can just see door after door. I don't think these people were necessarily this short, but that's just the weirdest thing is why they made the doors like this. For someone like me that's 6'2", that probably wasn't common for these people, but man, is it difficult on a guy like me.
See what I'm talking about? I can barely get through here without hitting my back on the top of the door.
Whew. It's a workout.
Here we are in one of the chambers in here. I don't really see any wood, but I'm gonna guess these were multi-story structures. Inside, they said they could be up to 4 stories tall. Very much the same as what you hear in Chaco. And the brickwork is intricate, like we saw in Chaco, but maybe not quite. Maybe that's why it took them less time to build, is they didn't get as crazy with the small stones. These stones are very uniform in size, and while they're fit together nicely, it's not quite as tight as what we saw at Chaco, in my opinion so far, and maybe there's other spots in here that will disprove that. Maybe I spoke too soon. You see some of those patterns where they have like different rows of different sized stones. This one's a little bit jumbled, not as consistent. Sometimes you see like one row of skinny stones and then small there, but kind of decorative. But for the most part, these walls are a little chunkier, I guess is how I would say it. And I wonder, was this here like a fireplace of some sort, a hearth? And was this a room that got sealed off by these people when they abandoned it, like they did in Chaco? Look at that, that looks like that was definitely a sealed off door.
So by 1300, these people left the area and migrated elsewhere. And when they left, they said that they sealed off entrances to rooms. And I think that might be another example that we've seen a few at Chaco between here of that.
Looks like there might be a pathway that will go into other rooms. And part of me is saying yay, and the other half of me is saying, oh no, my back, it's killing me. Here's another nice view. From up here, you can't really go into these, I guess. So part of me is relieved now and part of me is sad. But I like this view here of that window looking straight through. And then right behind me, you gotta watch where you're stepping. Yet another kiva, a place where they certainly did rituals and religious things. And there's some more wood, original wood, I presume. Probably almost a millennia old. It's amazing that someone like that can survive that long, but it's so dry out here that that's probably why.
Now, one key difference between here and Chaco is that this is the only great house, I think, in this region, whereas at Chaco, you got one after the other of these types of things. So you'll see much more quantity in Chaco, but this certainly lives up to the quality and the expectation of something on that level.
Okay, because it's so dark in here, I'll trade the bending over for the dark and the cool. Oh wow, I'm guessing because I see core samples taken from here, that much like at Chaco, this must be an original room. You can see some graffiti up there, which gives me even more confidence this is original wood, hundreds of years old, maybe 1,000 years old. It's really crazy, that goes really far back. Really far back. Wowzers. Just one room after another, and they all have this wood. All of them. So far, anyway. You can even see like mud or adobe on top of it. I notice that these remaining rooms look out in these little rooms without roofs, some with sealed doors on the other side, but protected by plexiglass. So I wonder if these are unexcavated. There's another room with another off-limits room back there. I wonder what's in there. probably more of the same. And here's a room with a modern wood holding it up. So some reconstruction, but you could see there's another sequence of doors that goes out the other side. Oh look, there's a bat. They talk about bats roosting in these things, and there's one right there. So excuse me, Mr. or Mrs. Bat, but I just wanted to say that you're hanging on centuries old wood. Did you know that? You have good taste. Okay, I think we've reached the end of the complex, and maybe the end of the trail. And into the hot sun we go again. Oh boy. And here is the exit. And that wall that we saw when we first came in.
All right, folks, well, there you have it. Aztec Ruins National Monument. This place was amazing. If you like Chaco Canyon, you're gonna love this. And this thing does it, it rivals things you'd see at Chaco, especially that stretch where you get to walk in room after room and see all of that original wood, bats, and the renovated kiva. I mean, this place has it, and it's definitely worth making a stop at if you're ever in the Four Corners region of the United States.